Now let's start talking about the follower motion, and the very first kind of follower motion we'll discuss is the simple harmonic motion. So this is how we can depict a simple harmonic motion, where this is a datum OA. Alright, so the rotation of cam from this datum is, let us say, theta at any instant. If you talk about the total lift of the follower upon the rotation of the cam, that is h. Okay. Now, due to this much rotation of the cam, the displacement of the follower is y. Okay, so if I write down that h is the lift of the follower, okay, theta is the angle turned by the cam, from any datum, alright, and then y would be the displacement of the follower due to this much rotation, that is theta. Okay, so this is the displacement of the follower. Okay, if I have to calculate this y, y would be OA minus OB. Okay, so if I write it down geometrically, y is equal to OA minus OB. Now what is OB? OB is OA dash cos of theta. Okay, so first of all, let's look what is OA. OA is the half of the diameter of this circle, which is h. So this will be h by 2 minus OB. OB is the cos component of OA dash. Now OA dash is also equal to OA in length. So this would be h by 2 cos theta. This means y becomes a component of theta, because h is a constant value. So if I have to find out the velocity of the follower, it will be dy upon dt. Now as we know, y is a function of theta from this equation, that is y is equal to f of theta. I can divide and multiply by theta. Okay, so this will be d theta upon dt. Now what is dy by d theta? So h by 2 is a constant, so the differential of cos theta would be minus sine theta, and you already have a minus over here. This will be h by 2 into sine theta. Now d theta by dt is the angular velocity, so you will get omega over here. Okay, so the value of the velocity, or the linear velocity of the follower, will be equal to h omega by 2 into sin theta. Okay, so if I have to find out the maximum velocity, sin theta has to be 1. So your V max becomes omega h upon 2. V max is omega h upon 2. Make a note of this. Now if you look at the displacement diagram of the follower, right, so there are four components of that displacement. The first one, if you draw a displacement diagram like this, which gives you theta, that is the crank or the cam angle, and this is the amplitude y. Okay, so first you have ascent, means the follower goes up. So you have, let us say, this going up. So I will say this much portion is ascent. So I will say that the displacement is theta 1, or the rotation is theta 1. Now there is no motion of the follower, so this becomes a dwell period. Okay, so this is the first dwell. Okay, then let us say this is how it comes down. So this is your descent. The follower comes down and the rotation taking place is theta 2, and then there is again dwell. So this is one complete cycle, that is 360 degree rotation. So in that 360 degree, theta 1 is the rotation of, you know, during which the follower is moving up, and theta 2 is the degree of rotation of cam in which the follower is moving down, that is descent. So we'll talk about these two displacements only. So if I have to draw, or if I have to write down the uniform velocity of a particle which is moving on the circumference of the circle, that will be, so uniform velocity, this will be equal to pi into h by 2 t. Now time is displacement by velocity, isn't it? So if I talk about this theta 1 ascent, let us say, so time would be displacement, which is theta 1, and velocity is omega. So this would be pi into h by 2 into omega by theta 1. Okay, so this is what you get. Now if you talk about the maximum velocity of, you know, the follower in ascent, that would be in going from this point, let us say, to whatever point you go to, let us say this point, this is the point up till which the ascent is happening. So the angle would be theta in this case, isn't it? So whatever is the total displacement, we'll take that. In this case, we are assuming theta 1. So the maximum velocity of the follower during the ascent would be this. Similarly, if I have to find out the maximum velocity of the follower in descent, I will take, let us say, theta 2. Okay, so I'll write down the V max in ascent. This is equal to pi h upon 2 into omega upon theta 1. Okay, and V max in descent, this is equal to pi h upon 2 into omega upon theta 2. So note down these two values. Now we'll come to this v, that's the linear velocity at any theta. So if I talk about the acceleration would be dv by dt, dv upon dt. So now we know that v is not a function of t, it's a function of theta, right? So you will write down dv upon d theta into d theta by dt. So what is dv by d theta? You will get omega h by 2 into cos theta. So you will get omega h by 2 into cos theta into d theta by dt is again omega. You write omega over here. So omega into omega is omega square. So acceleration becomes omega square h cos theta upon 2. This is the value of acceleration. Like this is the value of velocity. Now the maximum acceleration would be when cos theta is 1 or theta is 0. So A max is equal to omega square h upon 2. So make a note of this. Okay, so this is how we write down the maximum acceleration of the follower. Okay, when theta is equal to 0 or cos theta is equal to 1. So I hope you have understood this motion analysis of the follower when it is having a SHM. Okay, so the two formulas or four formulas to note down is this one, then the maximum velocity, then the acceleration, and then the maximum acceleration. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. Now let's move on to the next kind of follower motion, in which the follower will have the motion in uniform, you know, acceleration and uniform deacceleration. So now let's move on to the next video.